Sri Lanka, a beautiful island, called paradise by many a traveller in ancient and modern times. A land of many faces, with lush tropical forests, pristine waters, and untamed wilderness. An island renowned for its still intact expanses of nature, untouched by man. Even this sanctuary is not immune to the march of time. In the fast-paced world of the 21st century, there are more people to make demands of their environment than ever before. And with more mouths to feed, we have seemingly resorted to the first method that seems to efficiently solve the problem of feeding people. Each morning, masses of fruit and vegetables are piled up at large trading centers. Here, they go through a process of buying and selling, and goods change hands before they are ultimately sent on their journey towards our tables. But what is truly the price we pay for our daily meal? In Sri Lanka, this question first seemed to gain momentum with news of kidney disease that seemed to crop up in predominantly agriculture-based regions of the country. And it is not the only consequence of the consumeristic way we live. Perhaps we've tried to hide the dirt under the rug, but the rug is growing into a mountain of garbage that we can no longer ignore. One company in Sri Lanka, called Bio Foods, has been fighting the mainstream for the last 25 years by growing and exporting produce with zero agrochemical use. Today, its founder and chairman travels to Dumbulla with his daughter and son-in-law to spend the day at some of their organic farms.
People are starting to awaken to the fact that their food is untraceable. Cannot seem to locate exactly where it's coming from, how it's being produced, who's producing it, who's being harmed in the process of it, etc., etc. So at BioFoods, we believe in traceability and we believe in transparency. We like to keep the entire production open to the public eye so that you know what you're purchasing.
So how exactly did this vision of chemical-free sustainability get its start?
81, I was poisoned by some food drink, and then I was hospitalized for a few days, and then I wanted to know how come this food chemicals influence human health. So that was a start, and then I wanted to exactly study what are the chemicals that use for food preservation or whatever, and then how this so-called artificial chemical can influence human health quickly or later. Then once I completed my postgraduate in food science and technology, and when I got opportunity to start my own company, I started BioFood Private Limited Sri Lanka.
Since then, they have amassed a large number of tough international organic certifications, including that of the United States, European Union, and Japan. In addition, they are also front runners of biodynamic agriculture and were the first certified organic and fair trade spice exporters of the world.
What he's not telling you is when he got first started, the fair trade model was not really a thing. Even without any fair trade regulation per se, we always gave the farmer their cost of production plus a premium to cover their cost and also to sustain a decent enough quality of life. A few years later, the fair trade logo that everybody is very familiar with now came into play. But it also took into consideration the welfare and the well-being of all the animals. So it ties in really nicely with organic because we don't use pesticides or insecticides. We don't need to kill these things to feed people. We've been doing it that way for many, many years.
It's this vision that makes them leaders in truly sustainable agriculture. As the documentary was being filmed, they were interrupted by one of their farmers who wanted to sing them a blessing as thanks for the way they now live their life as part of the BioFoods family. We were lucky enough to capture the moment as it happened. With their hearts full, they proceeded to fill their bellies with a traditional organic lunch served in lotus leaves, starting with some organic tamarind juice used to stimulate the appetite. It's a very satisfied group of people that then heads out to another farm in the nearby Pahalavava region. Here, beautiful organic fruit and vegetables grow in abundance, but it houses something far more rare, a secret weapon for BioFoods. It's their certified organic fertilizer.
Carbonic කෘෂි කර්මාන්තයේදී ගොවි මහත්වරුන් අතර තිබ්බ මතයක් තමයි මේ කාබනික වගාව කරද්දී අස්වැන්නේ මදිපාඩුවක් ඇති වෙනවා කියන එක. මේ කාබනික පොහොර ගොවි මහත්වරුන් පාවිච්චි කරන කාබනික පොහොරේ ගුණාත්මක ප්‍රශ්නයක් තියෙනවා කියලා මේ අපි සොයාගත්ත අපේ කරපු පර්යේෂණ අනුව. ඉතින් බයෆුඩ් සමාගම සෑහෙන වියදමක් දරලා රුපියල් මිලියන 20කට වැඩි ආයෝජනයක් කරලා අපි අලුත් කාබනික පොහොරක් නිෂ්පාදනය කරා.
Indeed, a combination of soil microbes that no longer naturally coexist in the soil is introduced to a substrate of organic soil. The waste of unstressed, free-range animals are added and subjected to a process that takes months. This fertilizer is mostly used by farmers who once used to rely on conventional synthetic fertilizers.
වීදම විතර අස්වැන්නක් ලැබෙන්නේ ඊට පස්සේ මේ බයෝෆ්‍රූට් ආයතනේ කාබනික පොහොර හඳුන්වලා දුන්න අපිට මම ඒකෙන් ගෙනල්ලා පාවිච්චි කරලා ගොවිතැන් කරා ඒක සාර්ථක අස්වැන්නක් අපිට ලැබුණා කිසිම ලෙඩ රෝගයකුත් නැහැ කිසිම ප්‍රශ්නයකුත් නැහැ හරිම හොඳයි මේ පොහොර දැන් අපි දිගටම පාවිච්චි කරන්නේ ඒව තමයි
We also convinced a rather camera shy lady to express her opinion.
දැන් අවුරුදු 4ක් විතර යොමු වෙලා කාබනික වගාවට ඇත්තම කියනවා අපිට හරි හොඳයි හරි සන්සෝසයි මේ පොහොරේ කාබනික අරයි යන එක ඉස්සර කුවිනාශක වලින් අපේ ගංගොල් සෑහෙන්න ඉන්න අකුගඩු දිය වෙලා ඒ කියන්නේ අපිට මේක ඉතර බයක් නැහැ අය පේන්නේ දින්නේ විදිය වුණා ගන්නෑන කිසිම මේ සෞඛ්‍යයක් කිසිම කරදරයක් නැහැ අපි හොඳට වැඩ කරලා යනවා ගෙදර
While these farmers are happy, the organic agriculture field in Sri Lanka is not without its problems.
කාබනික කෘෂිකර්මය කියවම කාබනික කෘෂිකර්මය කියන වචනේ හරියට ලිහිල්ව මේ ලංකාව තුළ පාවිච්චි වෙනවා මම හිතන්නේ ඒකේ මූලික හේතු වශයෙන් දකින්නේ ඒකේ නියම අර්ථකථනයක් වැටහෙන්නේ නැහැ මොකද කාබනික කෘෂිකර්මය කියවම ඒකට ජාත්‍යන්තර නීති රීති පද්ධතීන් ගොඩක් එකතු වෙලා තියෙනවා යම් කෙනෙක් යම් දෙයක් කාබනික කියලා සඳහන් කරනවා නම් ඒ සඳහා තත්ත්ව පාලනයක් තියෙන්න ඕනේ ඒ සඳහා සහතිකර ආයතන නමක් තියෙන්න ඕනේ. ඉතින් අපි දැකලා තියෙනවා ලංකාව වෙළඳපොළ තුල තියෙන බොහෝ දේවල් කාබනික සහ වසවිස නැති කියන ලේබල් එකෙන් තියෙනවා. නමුත් එහි අපි දැකලා තියෙනවා බොහෝ අඩුපාඩු ඒවා බොහෝ දේවල් ඒකෙන් ඒ කියන සම්ප්‍රදායන් පිට දේවල් තමයි තියෙන්නේ. එතකොට මේ කාබනික කෘෂිකර්මය තුල අදා අඩංගු යුතු බොහෝ දේවල් අපි මූලික වශයෙන් කතා කරනවා යම් භාණ්ඩයක් කාබනික කියලා ගැහුවොත් ඒ තුල තියෙන්න ඕනේ ඒක සහතික කරපු ආයතනේ අංකය. තොරේ අංකය නොවනවනේ කාබනික භාණ්ඩය බාට පත් වෙන්නේ නැහැ. ඒ ඒ සහතිකර ආයතනේ පවා ලංකාව තුල ලොකු කියන ආයතනේ ඇතුලේ සහතික වෙලා තියෙනවනේ.
In fact, everything from the land to farmer groups to the processing facilities and processors, followed by the distributors and final sellers, all need to be certified in order to claim proper organic status. At each stage, there are inspection bodies that ensure that the standards of each certification are met each year. Clearly, to claim that a product is certified organic is no small task.
So now that we're at the juncture of 25 years gone and over with, The next era for biofoods is really to convince people that this is a lifestyle. This is not just one product that you happen to buy. What we do here doesn't hurt animals. What we do here doesn't hurt people. And what we ultimately produce doesn't hurt our bodies.
This allows biofoods to commit itself to preserve the gift of clean water, clean, fertile soils, and clean, fresh air for generations to come. It is the safety that this brings to all living things that drives biofoods forwards. Always hand in hand with nature, they head towards a bright future that they constantly strive to make brighter.